Begin. A lot has changed in Saint-Paris. The Bourgeois family has come a long way since living under a bridge, and they've definitely outgrown the apartment they lived in for a while. The mayor was finally able to repurchase the Grand Paris Hotel and move back in. Translation: I gave in to willful suffering and did the thing I hate. Don't ask how I managed to do the impossible and make an above-ground swimming pool on top of a 7-story building. It's a nightmare I refuse to relive. Anyway, the hotel is important as it turns out everyone loves coming here, all day and all night, even Marinette, even Lila. Chloe's room is slightly accurate. She mostly spends her time seeking validation in her magic mirror. Unfortunately for Chloe, the mirror has other things in mind.
What wouldst thou know, my queen?
Magic mirror on the wall. Who is the fairest one of all?
Famed is thy beauty, Majesty. But hold, a lovely maid I see. Rags cannot hide her gentle grace.
No!
Alas, she is more fair than thee.
Alas for her. Reveal her name.
Lips red as the rose, hair black as ebony, skin white as snow.
Du Pencheng? Du Pencheng! Ridiculous! Utterly ridiculous!
As it turns out, Marinette, but secretly Ladybug, forever remains Chloe's biggest rival, and no matter how time passes and life went on for everyone,
alas, she is more fair than thee.
The mirror would continue to torment Chloe every night, reminding her that she will always be second to Ladybug, also known as Marinette. The hotel also attracts a lot of musicians. We'll be right back. Besides the hotel, I've also built their high school. The school has become another great place for friends to spend time together. The bakery also has a new roof, which Sabine loves to enjoy in the mornings while Marinette sleeps. Speaking of Marinette, I also redid Marinette. A new Marinette also means a new ladybug. Frankly, it's a shock to all of us. New Marinette now lives beside a new park. Marinette tries to sneak off to the park, but is caught by Wang Fu, who visits the bakery sometimes, and is very friendly with Marinette's mom. Natalie is an astronaut for some reason. Later that day, Luka drops by the bakery as a favor to his sister. He meets Marinette for the first time and thinks she's a funny girl. But, he's finally found inspiration for his next song.
I believe in miracles.
The next day, Tomo enjoys Andre's ice cream and enjoys nature, which means Kagami finds an opportunity to leave the house. She goes to the bar where she comes across some unusual people. Kagami decides leaving the house is highly overrated. She returns home and spends time writing love letters to Adrian Agreste. Speaking of Agreste, the Agreste family has made new sleeping arrangements. Back at the bakery, Alaya's parents drop by. Marinette thinks about ladybugs and Tom can't stop suspecting his daughter is up to something. Meanwhile, Marinette's grandmother Gina is living her best life. Unfortunately, her grandfather is living his worst life, dutifully reminding everyone that's not how
it's done.
Next time, since Adrian has a crush on Marinette, I put both of them in a situation literally nobody asked for.
Kiss, kiss, fall in love.
Hey! Hey, hey, hey!